अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड इन गुड हेल्थ। वेलकम टू जूम ऑनलाइन क्लास। आई एम योर साइंस टीचर एंड टुडे वी विल डू द रिवीजन ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 7, दैट इज सॉल्यूशन एंड सस्पेंशन, एज वेल एज वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ दिस चैप्टर एंड द रिमेनिंग टॉपिक्स दैट आर लेफ्ट। सो यू हैव टू लिसन ईच एंड एवरी टॉपिक वेरी केयरफुली। So students, now let us discuss the objectives of the chapter number 7, that is solution and suspension. So here the number one, you have to shade the correct circle. So the number one objective is more than dash of the earth's surface is covered by a strong solution of salt. So here we have three options, 1/3, 2/3 and 3/4. So the correct option is 2/3. Another one is, if a solid will not dissolve in a particular solvent, it is called insoluble, number two soluble, or concentrated. So the correct option is insoluble. The third statement is, dash is an alloy of copper and zinc. So you have three options, brass, bronze, and solder. So the correct option is brass. The fourth one is, the water which has dissolved the minerals of calcium and magnesium in it is called dash. So you have again three options, seawater, hard water, or soft water. So the correct option is hard water. Fifth one is, antifreeze is a mixture of ethylene glycol and dash. First one option is water, salt, and third one is gas. So the correct option is water. The sixth objective is that dash is an alloy of copper and tin. So again you have three options, brass, bronze, and solder, and the correct option is bronze. The seventh one is, a dash can allow light to pass through it. And here in seventh statement, the correct option is solution, because solution can allow light to pass through it. In option 8, gases dissolve better in dash water. So the which one is the correct option? Boiled, cold, or warm? So the correct option is cold. Changing the temperature does not affect the solubility of liquid, right? And number 10 is, chalk is dash in water. Soluble, miscible, or insoluble? The correct option is insoluble. Number 11 is, calamine lotion is an example of dash, solution, alloy, or suspension? So the correct answer is suspension. And the 12th one is, an alloy of lead and tin is called dash, brass, bronze, or solder? And in the 12th option, the correct answer is solder. In the 13th statement, there is objective, dash is a solvent made from petroleum, and here ethanol, alcohol, or turpentine hai. So the correct option is turpentine. In 14, fizzy drinks are solution of dash, gas, sugar, and flavor in water. So here the correct option is carbon dioxide. Number 15 is, a suspension can be separated into its components by evaporation, filtration, or sublimation. So a suspension can be separated into its components by filtration. So here are the some few objectives from chapter number 7, and you have to learn all these objectives. So student, now let us discuss about a dilute solution. A dilute solution is a weak solution or one having a little solute. So a solution which contains a small amount of a solute dissolved in a solvent is called a dilute solution. Like for example, if you take a amount of a sugar in a small quantity and amount of water is large, then it will form a dilute solution. Like another example is of a vinegar. In a vinegar, you can see that there is a small amount of acetic acid and a large amount of a water. So it is also an example of a dilute solution. Another example you can see in the dilute solution is of a seawater, where you can take a small amount of a salt and a large amount of a water is present. So and it also form a dilute solution, because the amount of a salt is small and the water amount of a water is large. Now let us discuss that what are the concentrated solution. So a concentrated solution, it contains more solute and it is also called the strong solution, whereas the dilute solution is called the weak solution. So in a concentrated solution, a solution which has a large amount of a solute for a certain volume of a solvent is called a concentrated solution. Let us compare both the solutions. A dilute solution has a small amount of a solute in a large amount of a solvent, whereas in a concentrated solution, a concentrated solution has a large amount of a solute in a small amount of a solvent, because in a concentrated solution it contains more solute and it is called a strong solution. Whereas when you talk about the dilute solution, it contains less solute and it is also called a weak solution. How can you make a concentrated solution weaker? We can make a concentrated solution weaker by adding more amount of a water, so it will form a make a concentrated solution weaker. So now let us take an example of a concentrated solution. A solution with a large amount of a solute is called a concentrated solution because it contains more solute and it's called a strong solution. Like we can add a little or a lot of a solute. For example, putting the spoonful of a sugar into a cup of a tea. Like if you keep on adding more and more sugar in a cup of a tea, the solution will become concentrated. So students, and now we have discussed about the concentrated solution and a dilute solution. The concentrated solution, it contains more solute and it is also called the strong solution, and the dilute solution, it contains less solute and it is also called the weak solution. So now let us discuss about the saturated solution. So a solution that contains the maximum amount of dissolved solute at a given temperature is known as a saturated solution. A saturated solution is one that will not dissolve any more solute at a room temperature. A solution which cannot dissolve any more quantity of a given substance, and it is said to be saturated. Like for example, if you take a salt or sugar that dissolve in water, and if we go on adding more and more salt to water, we will eventually reach at a stage where more salt or sugar will not dissolve and the solution now become a saturated one. So adding more salt will stay at the bottom of the container. Now look at this picture. Here you can see the an example. You can see there is sugar and water is present, and a fixed quantity of a water can dissolve only a fixed quantity of a sugar. So when a substance cannot be dissolved further in a solution, then the solution is known as a saturated solution. So you have a question also in your neat copies that what is a saturated solution and what effect does warming have on a saturated solution. So in simple words, you say a saturated is one that will not dissolve any more solute at room temperature. So what are the effects of warming a saturated solution? Like if we warm a saturated solution, what will happen? The distance between the molecules increases with the rise of the temperature, thus more solute will dissolve in it. What is a supersaturated solution? A supersaturated solution contains more dissolved solute than required for preparing a saturated solution and can be prepared by heating a saturated solution, adding more solute and then cooling it gently. Excess dissolved solute crystallizes by seeding supersaturated solution with a few crystals of the solute. So now what is suspension? When a solid does not dissolve in a liquid, a suspension is formed and the solid is said to be insoluble. How you are going to define the suspension? Suspension is a mixture of small insoluble particles in a liquid or a gas, and you can take an example of calamine lotion, medicine and sea water in suspension. So in other words, you can say that what is suspension? Suspension is formed when a solid does not dissolve in a liquid and remains suspended in a liquid for a time. What are the properties for the suspension? Like a suspension does not allow the light to pass through it. Suspension is not a homogeneous mixture as well. A suspension can be separated into its part by the filtration. You can take an example of chalk. The chalk is insoluble in water, and if a little chalk powder is shaken up with water, it will form a suspension. You can also take an example of a soil, that a suspension is also formed if a little soil is shaken up with water. Another example can be of cement powder. Cement powder is mixed with water, also form a thick suspension that is called slurry. Indigestion mixture is also an example of a suspension. So students, now let us discuss that what is meant by the solubility of a substance and what effect does the temperature has on the solubility of a substance. So what basically the solubility is? So the basic definition is the solubility of a solute is the number of grams of that solute which will dissolve in 100 grams of water at a particular temperature. Or you can say that the solubility of a substance is its maximum amount that can be dissolved in a specific amount of solvent, right? So what effect of the temperature on the solubility of a substance? The effects of temperature on the solubility of a substance are like as follows. Like first one is solid, like solid that will dissolve better in the hot water. When you talk about the gases, and the gases dissolve better in a cold water. And now let us talk about the liquids. Liquids are said to be miscible if they dissolve in water and immiscible if they do not mix with water. And changing the temperature does not affect this. So students, now let us discuss about the miscible and immiscible. So have to define both. Like the main difference between the miscible and immiscible is when we discuss miscible, a miscible mixture is a mixture of two or more liquids that completely combine to form one solution. Like for example, alcohol and water. And when you talk about the immiscible, an immiscible mixture is a mixture of two or more liquids that does not mix completely. Like for example, oil plus water. So what is a miscible? Miscible substance fully mix in all proportions. As I have told you, the example is alcohol plus water. An immiscible substance never fully mix in any proportions. You can take an example of a oil and water. So dear students, hope you understood all the lecture. Thank you so much. Stay home, stay safe.